have entered the Plumbing Business Success Zone, teaching entrepreneurs the business of plumbing. This is Potty Talk Live, recorded live every week. Turn on notifications to never miss an episode. Now your host, Richard Behney, the Million Dollar Plumber.
Hey, plumbing pros, welcome to the 333rd episode of Potty Talk Live. Hey there, I'm your host, Richard Behney, the Million Dollar Plumber, along with my co-host, the lovely Laura, where we're talking the business of plumbing, how to systemize, stylize, and monetize your plumbing business. All right, how's everyone doing tonight? Great? I know. Speechless. I'm looking forward.
You're speechless? Well.
I know I say that every week.
You do say this
But
every
especially,
week.
I love our guest.
Mm-hmm. You love her?
Yeah. I love our guest here. In fact, let me give the title here of tonight's episode.
All right.
Google Guaranteed Success.
Ah.
Wouldn't you like guaranteed success?
I would.
All right. If you listen to our guest tonight, you'll be guaranteed Google success.
100%.
All right. Okay, so we'll have her on. I'm gonna...
If not, you get all your money back from watching tonight's show.
There we go. I'll go along with that. Okay. All right. How you doing, sweetheart? It's good to see you.
Thank you so much.
We've been kind of like two ships have been passing during the day here.
A little bit.
Doing our own thing.
Mm-hmm.
It's good to see you.
Good to see you. Hey, all right. Daniel Tanner.
And it's good to see everyone here. All right. All right, Daniel. All right. Thank you. You already started here. You know what to do. The regulars here. If you're watching live, you're part of live social audience, please type live in the comments. Mm-hmm. If you're watching the replay, please type replay. Let us know you caught the replay.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're listening to the podcast, you know what to do. Just keep on listening. All right. Here we have Aaron. Did you get that workout in, Aaron? All right. GB's in the house. GB's live. Yeah, you are live, baby.
Live, baby.
All right. Mm-hmm. Who else we have here? So Jacob. All right. Hey, I think Jacob, weren't you in the Success Academy live Q&A today? All right. I think I saw you there.
Mm-hmm.
Good to have
Joe
you there.
Martinez.
Joe, all right, man.
How's
Joe's live.
Nice?
All right.
Because next week is November. How's that even possible?
It's November?
I don't even know. Next week is November 1st.
Daggone.
Didn't 2021?
Time flies. Are we just getting old?
No.
Okay.
Hey, Matt Dillon.
All right.
No, we are not. Other people are. We are not.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Dylan. Dylan was the one.
Dylan.
Oh, yes.
We were talking about you, Dylan.
Dylan, we were just talking about you with our guest. So
right.
Pay attention.
There we go.
Anyway, and
all
Halloween
right.
is coming up. Halloween. Mm-hmm. Everybody's probably got little kids. Remember when we used to
What are you dressing up for Halloween, baby?
Oh, I could tell the look. I can totally read you. What if nothing?
I'm Catwoman?
As someone that hands out candy. That's who I am.
Okay, Jason's live. Good to see you, brother.
But Halloween, I mean, that was a big thing when we had little kids. Now, not so much.
It is, yeah.
But it's a thing. So, hey, Joseph.
Yeah, I remember our kids getting all dressed up, handing out.
And in Indiana, it was always, most of the time it was cold, right?
It's kind of right.
So miserable.
Yep.
Miserable Halloween Eve.
All right. Anthony, welcome, brother.
Anthony, nice to have you.
All right. Jax Plumbing.
Jax. Wonder why it's Jax.
Jax. All right.
Hey, Ashley.
Ashley's
why,
live.
Why is it Jax?
Yeah.
J-A-X, because that wasn't his name, so I wonder if he's like in Jacksonville.
Steven's live. Maybe? Good to have you here, brother.
Hey, Steven. So, what are we talking about tonight? What are we going to be?
Google.
Google.
How Google will guarantee your success. I say, I always, I said it today in the during the Success Academy live Q&A or whatever it came out. I don't know if we got onto it, but it came out. Hey, you got to have the Google thing down.
You do.
You got to play this game, okay? It's just how it is. And you got to play
rebel
it well.
All you want,
and the great news is,
hey,
is you can be a little guy and play it well, and you can compete with the big guys, okay?
Sure.
So, well, hey, let's get our guest on.
Shall we?
Okay. Was that Aaron Ketchum?
That was Aaron, yes.
All right. All right.
That's what you told me.
All right. Can't wait.
Meet you, Aaron.
All right. Can't wait.
Yeah.
Let's get some clients out of my hometown, Dayton, Ohio.
Dayton, Ohio.
All right. All right. Let's bring our guest on here, our expert, Miss Katie Donovan, founder and president of Home and Local Services. Dun, 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 dun.
An all-around good gal.
Yeah, she is. We love her. She's fun.
We do.
I know she loves all of our plumbing companies.
Yes.
Has a heart.
Mm-hmm.
That's one of our favorite things.
Yes.
Has a heart, and she's smart. Has a heart, and she's smart.
I do think it's interesting you brought me on the 333rd show, like half evil.
Right.
All the way to evil.
Well, I think you have probably a little
we'll
bit of
sure
wild side, a little bit of
right.
evil.
Right. Bring you back to this. Half evil.
666. Yeah.
Check out her glasses.
Show.
So you can see there's a little something there. All right.
A little bit of rebellion.
Hey, it's good to have you on here.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you guys so much. I really love being with you guys, love learning from you guys just as much, and really appreciate the opportunity.
Well, we're happy to have you here. So I know you've got questions and stuff. Say a little bit about home and local services, what you guys do, and all that kind of stuff. And go ahead and bring her full screen there. There's her glasses.
There you go.
That's right. I, as was introduced, run Home and Local Services. We are a digital agency, full service digital agency, focused squarely in the home services space. Nowhere else. It's a very unique industry. You have to be very good at what you do in this specific industry. So all of our services are around the home and local services space, from plumbers to electricians, HVAC techs, but all in that same vertical. And we do everything digital marketing, from websites to Google My Business, local service ads, Google Paid, Bing, Yelp support, Facebook, the whole gamut. And our entire agency is certified. We require it. And we're also a Google Premier partner. We're very proud of that. Only the top 3% of agencies in the United States actually get that Google Premier partner badge.
Sweet.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. Okay.
Home Local Service working on Google platform, baby.
Awesome.
That's right.
Okay.
They've been amazing. Thank you, Lisa. Yeah, they are.
I believe that's Full Speed Plumbing out in
Washington. You know, it is, and I appreciate that, because one thing I think, you know, I've never done this. Normally I introduce myself just the way I just did, but one of the things I think that makes us really different, and I think a lot of people say this, but our whole team, we only hire based on one thing, and that's give a hoot. Normally we don't say hoot. I don't know how many ears I might offend.
I appreciate it.
Yeah, right. and then we train on everything else. Really what we care more about is that our people care about your people. Hi, Ashley.
Hi.
Our people care about working with our clients, working, we call them partners internally, working with our partners. And I think a lot of people can say they do digital marketing, but not a lot of people can say they truly care and feel like they're partnered with everybody they work with.
Mm-hmm. Awesome.
Yep.
And I know our clients would attest to that. They really feel like they've got a partner.
Yes.
With you guys. So.
And I love that. Again, it's the heart that's important. We know we get hit on, guys out there, you know, the companies. We get calls every day of, you know, so-and-so and get us to the top of this list and Google and blah, 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 and that kind of stuff. And so, you know, I know what it's like, you know, getting hit. Mm-hmm. But I love the heart for everyone at Home and Local Services. It's hearts first. That's what's attracted us. Mm-hmm. I know they won't brag on themselves, but I know even Katie herself has done work for people that aren't even her clients, mm-hmm. just because she cares.
Kind of bailed them out here.
You know, and she brought us to the talk to sales. You'll have an opportunity to, we'll give you a link or whatever at the end or whatever, how, if you're not with Home and Local Services, or just at a minimum want to check them out, which I believe you should, we'll give you that link to be able to check them out. But they're not about pushing sales and that kind of stuff. They're about helping first, mm-hmm. which is what we get that as well. You help first, you wind up real people in, because they there's a relationship there, and
right.
they can see the value and they feel the value, more importantly, feel right. it, which is a big deal.
Yes.
So,
absolutely.
Well, we know you just said Home and Local Service does a bunch of stuff here, digital stuff here, but we're focusing on the Google side of things.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to play the plumber, and I'm not far off from this, and still thinking, you know, so I'm going to ask these questions, even though I'm not far off. Right. I kind of know the answer now, but there was a time where I really didn't know the answer.
That's true.
So
go back to those days.
So I'm going back to those days. Okay. A couple days ago. What is, yeah. you know, I hear about what is Google GMB, Google My Business, and then there's this Google AdWords, you know, and SEO,
LSA, and
you know, how's that play in? What is it? What is all this? What is it?
No, I appreciate that. Sometimes we forget ourselves and we'll start talking about something at work and I'll realize we just listed out the entire alphabet. Like, did you look at their SEO to see the GMB and see the GMB's, you know, LSA rank? I mean, it gets kind of humorous, but I always like to start with the basics, like Google. I mean, everybody knows what Google is, but we don't really talk about what Google is. And to me, Google is what used to be our yellow pages. It's our television. Now we watch, you know, go to Google to find the latest shows. It's what used to be our billboards with display ads. It's really all of our marketing that we used to do traditionally mm-hmm. has moved online. Mm-hmm. And more people will touch the Google local service ads, Google GMB, right, will touch Google than any other marketing product that's out there. Mm-hmm. So if you're not in Google, you're not there, right? Your customers aren't finding you. I believe
exist.
I was reading you don't exist. It's crazy to me. I was talking a couple of weeks ago about Google GMB, excuse me, that Google My Business.
Mm-hmm.
And we always talk about that really as being that yellow pages. But 91% of adults will use that Google My Business to help find a local business. 91%.
And what is
91.
That?
91.
That's crazy. Well, I hear you say Google My Business. What is that? I don't know what that is.
Whenever you do a search for a local business, whether you're searching for that business by name or you're searching for that business by like a business line, plumber near me, for mm-hmm. instance, mm-hmm. that ad that pops up on the right hand side. And what we always tell people is the most expensive real estate isn't in LA, it isn't in New York, it's not in Singapore, it's Google. Mm-hmm. And so when Google takes half a page and dedicates it to something, we should all be paying attention, right? Mm-hmm. Every one of us. So Google My Business, when you do a search like plumber near me, or I saw Babe was on here and they're my favorite. I pick on them all the time and use them as examples all the time. But, you know, Babe Plumbing in Mankato, Minnesota, up on the right hand side, up will pop up your GMB. It has photos, customer reviews, basic business information about your business, everything a customer would need to quickly identify that that's the service they need, and then use that to contact the business, either by going to their website, sending an email, sending a text, or making a phone call.
Right.
Okay.
Prime real estate.
Okay, I recognize. Okay, I know. I recognize that. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yes.
Bo says home local has been really taking
off for us. Yep. Love hearing that.
The checks are in the mail, you guys. The checks are coming out.
And Bo's right. There you have one. This is Katie fixed Google stuff for us before we even signed up. Mm-hmm. And so once we experienced the heart. Yep.
Oh, I love Evan too. No, it's really important for us to do that. We prefer to meet people that way, our partners that way. You know, a lot of companies will say, you know, we started out with the guarantee. If someone tells you, hey, you're going to be on page one, you're going to do it. I always say run the other direction, right? Run, as run. Fast as you can. It takes work. I always say, you know why, and I know Richard won't know this, but you know why more people don't lift weights? It's 'cause they're heavy. Right, that's Google. You've got to do the work, you got to put the effort in, otherwise, you know, you're not going to get the return out of it, and it is work. Mm-hmm. So we try and if you're not on Google, you're going to die. That's 100%.
That's right.
And that's a great point though that you said that, because there's so many parts to Google, like what you were saying. Mm-hmm. There is local service ads, there's GMB, mm-hmm. there's organic, there's you know, pay-per-click. Google, if you look at a page, well, and you look at a Google page, if you type in plumbers near me, there's 19 different products that can actually show on that page.
Wow.
And you've seen them, from video clips to frequently asked questions, mm-hmm. featured snippets, GMB, LSA. And you've got to be, in our day and age, as a business owner, you've got to be the master of as much of that space as you can.
Mm-hmm. So that brings up to a question I wanted to ask was, so why do I need this Google stuff for my business, my plumbing business? I mean, I have customers that call me, mm-hmm. you know, I've been working for, and so why do I need it?
I think growth is in Google, right? I mean, we can stay with our existing customers and have that, but growth is really in Google and Google's products. Mm-hmm. I always tell people, like, especially when you're starting out smaller, you don't need to be in all of those products. You really should just try and dominate in a few locations. Google My Business, again, because it takes up half of the page. Pay attention to the real estate. It's like Monopoly, right? Mm-hmm. I'd way rather have those two spots on Monopoly than have all the railroads. It's, mm-hmm. It makes a lot, right. You know, someone lands there. But Google My Business takes up half the page. And it's a great equalizer. You do not have to have an agency to be very good at GMB. You do not have to be a large business. You know, you don't have to have 25 trucks on the street to be successful in GMB. Just mm-hmm. a few little things that you need to do regularly. Mm-hmm. Focus on the fundamentals. Mm-hmm. I was talking a couple weeks ago about Vince Lombardi's book, and how one big chunk of his book talks about focusing on those fundamentals.
Mm-hmm. Right.
He would start at every single training camp, and they'd open up the playbook and start with the fundamentals. Mm-hmm. No matter how many years the people had been on the team, they'd open up that book, they'd read through the fundamentals, they'd practice every play, they would go through all of that, and that's what makes, you know, from good to great.
Mm-hmm. But the problem with Google My Business is it's very, very, very expensive. How expensive is it?
That was a good setup. And it's free, right? My second favorite four-letter word that starts with F, if anyone knows me. But it's a free service. I know. Our whole HR department today was like, Katie, can you get through this? Yeah. Swearing.
It is called Potty Talk. However, we do
that's
this
right.
as a family
right.
show. So,
yeah, no, but it's it's a free service. It's like I said, it's a great equalizer. You don't need an agency. You don't need to be a big company. You just got to go in there and practice those fundamentals, and you'll get that space. And one of the great things, too, about Google My Business is it's tied into so many different things. So if you get really good at your GMB, you're going to help your local service ads. You're going to help your SEO, which is how you rank on the page organically without the paid pieces. Mm-hmm. You're going to help the entire business. Babe, I know, and I hope you guys don't mind, I've asked you this before, if I could talk about your account.
Absolutely.
But just by fixing, we're fixing, not fixing, it wasn't broke, just by optimizing their GMB, we're able to get, I just looked today before I got on this call, 171% lift in phone calls just from GMB.
Oh, nice.
Yes.
Which is, again, free.
Free. Yes, free. Free. Yes. Free.
So, okay, so Katie, you want to give away a couple tips on what somebody can do, a plumbing business owner right now who knows that he's got his Google My Business listing but really hasn't done anything with it. What's a couple of things they could do tonight to help?
I simply call it my rule of five. So there's five things you should be doing on your GMB on the regular basis, I think, to be optimizing your GMB.
Write these down. Okay, go.
And by the way, I should back up. These are the five things I do on the regular. First thing you should do is just go in and make sure everything's as complete as you possibly can. Just read it. It's not hard. I always used to laugh because, you know, those tests we all took in high school where, like, you got to the end and the very last thing said, like, don't do anything and turn this in without anything, you know, because we didn't read to the end. You just go in and read it and just fill it out. It's pretty safe. But after that, it's my rule of five. If I have to count past five, I got to use this hand. If I count past 10, I got to take my socks off. No one wants to see it. So I try and keep it simple with the five. So at least five reviews a week. That's not, I mean, most of us are doing, even if you're single in a truck, you're doing, you know, 3 to 4 appointments a day. So I'm not asking for more than just one of those a day to convert to a review.
Right.
Google loves to be fed. My HR department told me not to say this too, but I always say Google's like a fat kid on Taco Tuesday, right? They like to be fed. They're like, could you use something different all the time? But those five reviews, five pictures, and everyone, when I say pictures, you know, recoils instantly. I'm not asking for you to come with a studio and studio lights. Grab your iPhone. The camera in the iPhone is better than the cameras that we used to have when I started out in marketing.
So
I mean,
true.
They're amazing.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Not you, though, Laura. Well, you're too young to know all of this.
I'm much too young.
And Katie, I got to throw in there about the pictures. Guys, we're not talking pictures of the wad, you know, the root ball that you pulled out of the drain that looks like a big rat. Okay.
Yeah, I think Katie's mentioned before, just take a picture of your truck.
Of your truck with
house.
The house in the background or something like that, you know.
And then Iron Man.
Hey, Iron Man.
Where have you been, Iron Man? Good to see you. Iron Man is a long time Potty Talk Live listener. Anyway, this is a little bit off subject, but it's about Google Guaranteed. I have noticed some companies in my area have more than one Google Guarantee in an area.
So hold that thought. I know that's a key thing. Mm-hmm. I was thinking about as well. Iron Man, we'll get to that question. I want you to finish the five, though, because this is very important. And we'll circle back around.
Because that comes up every single time Iron Man on every time we talk about LSA, it comes up because some people just make their own rules. But so for the rule of five for your GMB, those five reviews, five photos. I love the idea of the truck. We spend a lot of time and money on our brand. Just snap a picture of the truck. People love to see it.
Of course.
It's branded. Yes, I love it. Two posts. So on Google My Business, there's an opportunity to put a post. And here's a little secret about that post. That is a huge driver of organic ranking.
Okay.
So what you put in that post will not only help your GMB come up, but will also help your website ranking. Not to nerd too much, but it's something called search justification. And Google looks at GMB as a huge driver of what's called search justification. Mm-hmm. So I strongly recommend, you know, don't put out there like, look at us cleaning a drain. But if you do things like, you know, drain clearing in Hutchinson, Minnesota. Great team we work with. Good, got it done in a day. That kind of thing. Like all of those keywords. Think about what your customers say when they call you. Like, can you get it done in a day? You know, what kind of services do you offer? Little geo terms. I'm kind of sneaking in there.
Yes.
But it's such an easy thing. There's no other place that you can directly add content to Google that's indexed as quickly as it is besides that GMB post. Man. So it's a really kind of secret sauce that a lot of people overlook.
So every time you're doing a post, keyword stuff it. That's what you call it. You just you put as many keywords in there as possible.
Mm-hmm. Yep, and it's one of the only places you can still keyword stuff. A couple of years ago, Google, we used to do that for organic ranking, so how your page comes without paid. And we used to keyword stuff on that. The old joke I used to say is a copywriter goes into a restaurant, a watering hole. Like, that's keyword stuffing. Right. The only place you can do that still is on your GMB and actually get away with it.
And get away with it. And
there's also a section. Yep. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and benefits. It's huge.
Yep.
There's also a part of your GMB that's called Google Q&A. And whereas this doesn't directly affect the rank of your GMB, it has been shown to be hugely beneficial in helping communicate to your potential customers, answer the questions they want. And they do see a 16% lift in conversions when people use that Google Q&A. Wow. And ultimately, all of this is great. I can talk to you about rank until I'm blue in the face. No one cares. We care about phone calls. We care about form fills, and we care about chats. So if we can do something that helps improve that conversion rate, which means getting a phone call, a form fill, a chat, someone reaching out to you, that's a great little spot. So 5 reviews, 5 pictures, 2 posts, 2 Google Q&As a month. That's it. And then updating, making sure you review that Google My Business profile every month. And here's a dirty secret why. And I Iron Man's going to be interested in this because of his competitors in his market. But anybody can make suggestions to Google about your GMB. So if you ever notice, like, your phone number just changes. I had one company we helped who somebody suggested a name change for their business and changed their name on their group. I know it's shocking. Mm-hmm. They can change your hours. You can do all kinds of kind of, most of the time it's somebody trying to help you out. They make an accidental like suggestion, but you can also be very devious there and suggest that they're open from 8 to 9.
Right. Yeah. So that's true. You
always, this is professional plumbing. It does happen.
Yes. Go and check your profile. Make sure someone didn't
do accidentally it. Or
right. Or not accidentally. Right. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's just those 5 things. It sounds like a lot, but it really isn't. 5 reviews a week, 5 pictures a week, 2 posts a month, 2 posts for Q&A, and then those monthly GMBs.
Yes. So set a reminder, guys, on your phone or put it on your calendar. Block it, some time out once a week to take care of that, because it's just as important as running the plumbing calls.
Right. Mm-hmm. Even maybe more so. I mean, this is the business. We talk about this. This is something you can do. I can do it.
Yes.
If I can do it, you can do it. Okay. And it's what Google wants.
Right.
What Google likes.
Carmen's got a question. Hey, Carmen. And Carmen is a Success Academy member and been with MDP for a long, long time. Okay. So just got here. What are you talking about posting? We do that. Hal, apologize for backing up the conversation. So it's posting right in Google My Business, right?
Yep. Yep. Okay. It's actually a tab. So when you're logged into your Google My Business, whether you're on the phone application or the desktop, there's a tab that says posts. You'll click on that. Most likely it'll be empty. And you have a couple of different types of posts you can make. You can make COVID updates, which hopefully things will go away soon.
Yes,
but you can make COVID updates. You can put just a quick update like Happy Thanksgiving, or you can actually put ads in as well, which we're big advocates of. We do it all the time. We suggest that people put ads in. Mm-hmm. So you can put in there like 63 or free drain clearing service. And, we'll come out to your house. We'll make sure your drain's cleared. If we can't clear it, we'll refund your money, because that's the drain you want to be standing in front of, right? When you can't clear within 30 minutes, because that's generally a bigger issue there. So we suggest you put that in there. It is so easy, Carmen. It literally walks you through what you need to fill out step by step. It automatically defaults for a week. I always tell people to stretch that out for a couple weeks, like 2 or 3 weeks, so that you get some good bang for your buck out of that. And Carmen, the reason why we were talking about it specifically is that not only helps your Google My Business page rank, so you're more likely to show. Now, if someone types in drains, that page will likely come up. But also it helps with your website, because they're all connected. So Google recognizes that you had a mention of drains on your GMB and will help rank your website as well.
Perfect. Thank you, Katie.
Okay. That's how it works.
There you go, Carmen.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, we'll be right back, Katie. Mm-hmm. Okay. And we'll be right back with answer Iron Man's question. Mm-hmm. But before we get back, to Miss Katie Donovan. I have something for you, okay? Her viewers here for joining us, and her, those that watch the replay or on the podcast here. Mm-hmm. All right, it's my Million Dollar Plumber Blueprint. All right, all the specs you need to build a successful, self-sustaining, and very profitable plumbing business. And I think we even kind of hit on this Google thing. I mean, it's an important spec, okay? But it's all in there for you, and it's free. Okay, it's free.
So many free things.
All right, simply type free in the comments. Or go to themilliondollarplumber.com/free to grab your free copy today.
Of the blueprint.
All right.
I'll be glad you did.
All right, let's get Miss Donovan back on here.
Miss Katie.
Okay.
Katie Donovan, president, an all-around good gal.
With home and local services.
I feel like I'm at a taping of Oprah. Like, you get a free blueprint, you get free GMP, right. You get like
a free car,
you get a free. That's right, exactly.
You get a blueprint.
That's right.
Yeah, we haven't made it up to the car status yet.
Guys,
right,
exactly.
It's coming. Hey, listen, one wrapped truck. I think we'd all go to fight like death blows over that right now.
That's what we need to do, babe. Is give away a wrapped truck.
Ooh, there we go.
Yeah,
that's a cool idea. Mm. Okay. All right, let's get right on that. Well, Iron Man had a question.
Yes.
About seeing his competition having multiple Google.
Google Guaranteed. So maybe say a little bit about Google Guaranteed.
Right.
Maybe, you know, mention what that is exactly, and then we'll go from there.
Yeah, and I see you placed it back up there, Iron Man. Yeah, so Google Guaranteed is actually called Google Local Service Ads. It's those on desktop, the three boxes that pop across the top. Or on mobile, only two places that pop on the top. And again, we talk about the importance of real estate. It's at the top of the page.
Top, top, top.
Position zero, actually, they call it.
Oh, really? Wow.
And we've gotten to that point in our lives where, if we have to wait more than a few seconds for something, we all get impatient for it. Mm-hmm. So a little interesting stat on that. When someone types in a search and the search result is returned, you'll notice on every single search result Google does, they actually put their time it takes to return that search. So it'll say like 1 million records in under, 1.3 seconds kind of thing. And that's something Google's been doing since the beginning. They're very proud of. But within 3 seconds, the consumer decides where to click next. One, two, three. Yeah. So that LSA is so important because they see it and they click it. Mm-hmm. So that's the local service ads. people are not supposed to have more than one local service ad per trade in a market. So you're technically not, I know what happens, but theoretically, you're supposed to have one GMB, one LSA, and if you get caught, Google can actually shut them both down. So you don't want to do that. The other nice thing about that, Iron, it's so frustrating when you see people kind of doing that. You can turn them in. But one of the things they're doing is they're actually kind of hurting themselves, because the way Google local service ads works is based off of how much of the consumer's area overlaps with your trade area, not how many times you're popping up. So if you actually have a larger area that you say you service as opposed to two smaller areas, right, that kind of overlap a little bit, you're actually giving Google a higher chance of ranking when a customer types in like plumber near me.
Mm-hmm. So, again,
if you, I was telling,
go ahead.
Sorry.
Nope.
Well, everyone tries to outsmart Google, and I'll tell you, we're not gonna. None of us are, anyway, right? I mean, I was saying before, it's the golden rule: he who has the gold makes the rules, and Google has the gold. So, if you just follow their rules, even though it's really frustrating when you see other people breaking it and showing up a couple of times, in the end, it always works out better when you just do it the way they want you to do it.
Yes. Exactly right.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, I'm sure if they do take you down, it's not an easy process to get brought back up. Right?
Not at all.
Because it's called the sandbox, right?
Right. So, and it is the game that you want to play. I mean, they are the game in town.
So you got to play by their rules.
Right.
Yeah.
And the rules aren't that hard to play by.
No. You can them or not. It doesn't really matter. Right. I mean, but you have to play by them.
Right.
So that's good.
Yeah, so Iron Man...
No, go ahead.
Yep. To combat that, what I would do is look at your service area inside GMB and make sure that you have it as wide as you are willing to go. Also make sure at Google Local Service Ads really ranks on three things they'll tell you. One is your responsive rate. So you got to make sure you're answering those LSA calls.
So kind of a lot of people want that a little bit. So we've got your LSAs, you've got a phone number there. And as soon as someone calls that phone number, that's when, and you answer, that's when you're charged, correct, for those
yes.
LSA ads?
Yep.
Okay, right. So,
yep.
No, go ahead.
Well, and you want to make sure you answer those. So many people want to leave those on 24 hours a day. They just leave that 24 setting. That can actually hurt you because if that responsive rate drops, like the one thing about being a small plumber is we don't have people that are taking our calls after hours like some of the big guys. So set the hours for when you're actually going to answer the phone because that helps improve your responsive rate. She'll actually help you outrank some of those big plumbers.
Right.
So a lot of people want to leave that open 24. I don't recommend it. I recommend when you're actually going to answer the phone.
Right. Right.
And those
some
hours
people may have an answering service. I mean, there's
Plumline.
Plumline is a great answering service mm-hmm. That does that.
Oh,
and so if you're going to turn your phones over to them at the end of the day, then yeah, you can have your Google My Business and LSA set for 24/7.
But you have to answer the call because that is because they'll penalize you for not answering a call.
Right. And even if you're one truck and you're answering the phones during the day and you're on a job site and the phone rings and you're like, oh, I can't or I'm muddy or I'm whatever, you're going to get dinged. So you absolutely have to make sure you answer the phone.
Right.
So. Yep, that's those three R's. So the responsive rate, mm-hmm. and this is where I was going with the Ironman, the radius, that's another really big one. So your responsive rate, your radius, and your reviews. So if that other company is splitting to two separate GMBs and leaving a review here and a review there, they're actually hurting themselves. Mm-hmm. If you put all of your reviews to one GMB that's tied to your local service ads, like Google My Business is tied to your local service ads, you get the reviews to go to that GMB. That actually helps increase your ranking for your local service ads as well. So doing it right, it's like going to the gym, but it pays off. You get those reviews, it helps increase that. You get a good star rating, it helps increase it. You have that right radius, and you make sure you answer the phone, the responsive rate.
Okay. Yes, and Google local service ads are really not that expensive, right? So what's an average if someone, that someone's going to pay for a call to come in?
It varies. I've seen it as low as $8 in some markets and as high as $46. But $46 for a phone call, I don't know about you guys, but I'll take all day and twice on Mondays, you know?
Right.
Mm-hmm. And for people that actually went out and searched specifically for a plumber for some sort of service. So it's normally a buying customer.
Right.
It's not some looky-loo that's through Angie's List or Home Advisor or one of those things. I mean, more than likely serious.
And the leads... The leads go right to you. So you'd mentioned Home Advisor, where sometimes they'll send it off to a couple different people, and you're all fighting over that leads.
Oh. Yeah. They say four.
It's trying to be
five,
nice. Case anyone from 15, Home Advisor.
No way.
20.
Yeah.
Right.
Dylan says, so how does Google track whenever a customer calls you from that Maps or GMB list? There you go, Katie.
So they actually have tracking on most of those. So you have to, if you want to turn that on, there's a little button.
LSAs as opposed to GMB, correct? Or can you turn on, I guess you can have different phone numbers, right?
Right. Sorry. So okay. He had mentioned GMB. In local service ads, that phone number that's published is actually owned by Google. So you don't have a choice. They're tracking that number.
Okay.
In your GMB or your map pack, you have a button you can turn on that allows Google to track those calls, or you can put a tracking number on it yourself and connect that to Google.
Perfect. So yeah, with the LSAs, as soon as someone dials that number, which again, Katie, you said Google gives you that number as soon as you set up your LSAs. As soon as someone dials that number, you answer it, and after how many seconds? Is it 20 seconds or something? That's when you're charged, or is it right away?
31. Yep.
Okay, 31.
31 seconds.
Anything over 30. So you're not going to get charged if some salesperson calls, and you end up hanging up or whatever. As long as it's within 30 seconds.
And that's a solid point because you can, I love local service ads. I could live off local service ads. If I could fill my board with local service ads for all my customers, that's all I would do.
Oh, yeah.
Because they're calls directly to you. You only pay when it's a call over 31 seconds. And if it's not a real lead, you can dispute it. We be judicious with your disputes. You don't want to dispute everything because it was an apartment owner and they can't buy. Google doesn't care.
No.
But if it was a bot or a spam or somebody calling about swamp coolers, and you live in northern Minnesota, you're not putting that in. So you can dispute those kind of things. And that's why I love local service. You're really only paying for a true lead. And I personally think the amount they charge for these leads are really fair. I mean, it's a really fair price for a very, very good lead.
In fact, I know, Katie, with our clients, tell me if I'm wrong or right here, we kind of tell them, even though we know they can dispute them, we say don't. Just because, especially starting at the very beginning, because we're kind of sensitive about what we're spending, we're kind of overly sensitive about it. And we don't want to come across as that customer that's always whining, you know, and focusing on that. And so we say put it down as a cost of advertising or marketing.
Right. I just let it go.
And because they are so low, just let it go. Mm-hmm. And then as you get a better feel for it down the road, a true one, then you can start, you know, throwing it in there. But at least get Google seeing you as,
right,
you know, someone that's not freaking out on them.
Right.
I agree. And that goes in, yeah, right to what Carmen's saying about the price shoppers. Mm-hmm. Price shoppers are shoppers. You know, I don't mean to be overly aggressive, but in this category, you're not getting on people. I mean, no one's calling plumbing just to see what the prices are. That's really a lead. And that's how Google will see it as well. They'll see it as a lead, and it's your job to convert them.
No one wakes up in the morning and wants to call a plumber. They're not calling just to get a price. They want to get it done. So, yeah.
Yeah, don't dispute those for sure.
Yeah. And going back to that point, I think it's valid. I wouldn't, if you, especially because it's part of the responsive rate. So disputing can help drive that responsive rate down. And at least until you're getting tons of calls, it's probably worth just letting them go.
Agree. And pay-per-click, I mean, LSAs, Google Local Service Ads, are really inexpensive, especially compared to pay-per-click, right? And pay-per-click is totally different, right? I don't know if you want to explain a little bit about how pay-per-click ads work.
Yeah, whereas LSA, you're paying for that lead, that phone call. Pay-per-click, you're literally just paying when somebody clicks. There's no guarantee of anything. There's no disputing that click unless you've got a bot, but that doesn't happen very often.
Right.
So, yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. So if someone types in plumber near me, those three local service ad boxes will appear at the top. If they call that, that's local service ads. They scroll down underneath it and see an ad for you, a paid ad, and they click on that, you're charged. Whether they called you, whether they emailed you, whether they bounced back off your page and went down to the next person, you get charged on pay-per-click. Right. So there's a lot that goes into pay-per-click, and that's why if I could fill my boards with just local service ads, I totally would.
Right. And it's way more expensive. I mean, those clicks aren't $8 for the most part.
No.
If someone did cover,
no, you can't.
You're paying a lot for that lead.
Right.
Yep. Yeah, in some markets, we see that as high.
We weren't a fan of the pay-per-click.
It didn't work for us.
Because you just you couldn't tell if they were real or not, where you still can get the, you know, maybe you get a rash of from the LSAs, mm-hmm. where, okay, they just seem to be shoppers or, right. you know, hard to turn them, you know, on that phone, the phone call. But at least you know, right? We knew.
And with pay-per-click, your competition could just sit there and go.
That was our fear. We thought our competition was running off our budget.
Mm-hmm. And then within half the day,
my budget was gone, so, you know?
Yeah. Right.
Google's gotten pretty smart about that. That doesn't happen very often anymore. I can't say it doesn't happen ever, but they've gotten really smart about where those clicks are coming from.
Oh, good.
So that doesn't happen. And really the key there is having a good conversion. Mm-hmm. If every three clicks results in a conversion, that phone call, form, filler, chat, mm-hmm. then pay-per-click will actually be good. It'll work out for you. Mm-hmm. If you don't have a very high conversion rate, that $10, $20, every time someone hits that little click, suddenly becomes $100,
right.
$120 just to get a phone call.
Right.
Right.
If you're lucky. So, okay.
All right. So it is a game. Mm-hmm. Guys, we got to play.
It's
the G game. The G game.
Mm-hmm.
Now,
G game.
Now, Katie, I'm going to ask you this. You know, how can we, how can we learn more about Google or have someone even take care of this for us? Because I tell my people all the time that, hey, you don't have to be an expert, but you got to know about it, but you don't have to be the expert. Mm-hmm. And this is definitely something that would be, for me, okay, I know about it, but I just don't, get a handle on all this. Google's always changing. Things are going on. I just much rather have someone take care of it for me.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So I want to point him your way. Mm-hmm. Is that?
Well, yes. And I appreciate that. I will tell you, though, that and we do appreciate that, and we're always willing to help. But the nice thing about the Google My Business and local service ads is that is something you can do on your own. We don't need an agency. As I said, you don't need to be a big company. Get into that GMB. Don't be frightened of it. Fill it out. Add those posts. Even if you do it wrong, you can delete it. It's a great tool. It's really, really simple. Mm-hmm. And then local service ads, if you don't have one, by all means, you need to be setting it up. You're actually already behind, right?
Yes.
Like if you don't have a local service ads account already, you're behind. Mm-hmm. If you have a local service ads and it's not performing, get in there and take a look and see if you can find what's going on. Like make sure you're adding photos in there. Make sure you've got all of the things you can filled out, like all of your business attributes filled out. Your hours are set correctly. Your radius is set correctly. It all does tie back to those reviews as well. And what I always tell people is if you get stuck, call us. We're totally willing to help. You do not need to be a client of ours. We'll help on the weekends if you're really, really busy. We talked to one of your clients last Saturday because he was driving his family somewhere just to try and get him. It was the only time he had a little window of time. We jumped on the call and walked through some things with him. Anything we can do to help, we're happy to help. Your success becomes our success as well, so we're always happy to help.
Love that. Yes, and to get more information, too, you can go out to our webpage, themilliondollarplumber.com, and go to the Power Tools section, and you'll see a home and local service link right there. You can fill out a form and get some information, have a phone call.
And you tell, as you see, they're not pushy. Mm-hmm. They are caring people and easy to talk to. So check it out.
Yes. And April Mathis, there's April. And I know you bailed the Bahama Plumbing out a couple weeks ago.
That one I do. Yeah, I know about that. Mm-hmm. They were having all kinds of problems.
Yeah.
So. And you got them bailed out. Mm-hmm. Right.
Mm-hmm. And, oh, thanks, Lisa, too. I actually have, I don't know how to get it out, but I could maybe send it to you guys. We have a little cheat sheet that has how you optimize your GMB and the rule of five for Google My Business, how you optimize your LSA and the rule of five for local service ads. I'd be happy to get that over to you guys.
Yeah, that'd be great.
People can just use it as a little checklist.
Perfect. Yeah, do that, and then we'll just put it in the comments. We'll link it here and pin it to the top of the comments on this episode.
All right. Great.
That's what Matthew just wrote was very controversial, by the way. When you fill out one of the tools we have is called a CPOP that lets us know what your capacity's at. And when you fill it out, you get 100 little confetti fires all over. And there's many people in our company who take credit for that, who say that was their idea. So it's very controversial that you brought that up. No, I'm not even going to get in that fight. I'm not even going to try.
It was Patrick's. I heard it was Patrick's.
Right.
Patrick O'Brien's. It was totally his idea.
All right, Miss Katie, a lot of great information there. Thank you so much for taking the time to share with us. Mm-hmm. I really do appreciate it.
Yes. And thanks for being so great.
We really value our relationship. We appreciate everything you guys have done with us, too. And I'll get that checklist over so you can get that out to anybody who asks for it.
That'd be great.
All right. Thank you, Katie.
Thanks, Katie.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.
We'll see
all right.
soon.
Take care.
And
Bye.
Stay warm there in Minnesota.
Minnesota. Bye.
Thanks, Katie.
All right.
Yeah, she's in Minnesota. She said it was already got a frost.
Already got a frost. Probably some snow.
Great information. Guys,
nuggets of gold there.
Rewind this. I mean, again, if you're watching the replay, rewind this. Katie really gave some great free information that you can do yourself. You don't need an agency. You don't need to be an expert, but you do have to take control of your listings on Google.
Right.
And it's not that hard.
You got to do it.
Don't
and it's stuff that the big companies aren't even doing.
Right.
Okay, they're there. They happen to be there because they just, got some reviews. Now they're big enough. Mm-hmm. And the other little guys aren't taking advantage of it and doing all these things.
So
this is a chance that you really can bypass or pass the big guys.
Absolutely.
Okay.
And
there's no reason.
If you're, one truck guy on your own, you had a teenage kid, have them help you or something, but you've got to get in and take control of your listing.
And I'm going to say, as I always say, you don't have to be an expert, but you got to be aware of it. You don't have to be an expert. Mm. You got other things to do here. I would say you can. I think you should take Katie up on her advice and do some of these things so that you understand it and know what's going on.
Right.
But ultimately, you're going to want someone, and we highly recommend Home and Local Services just because how they do it, they really are tops, and they actually care. And they're really pretty sharp at it. So you can see, the people we talk, they're very intelligent. She's a sharp cat, but she's also cool. She's a cool cat. You know what I mean? She's easy to talk to. I mean, so you can talk to these people, being a guide is from the trenches. Mm-hmm. I don't feel like such a dummy.
Right.
They don't make me feel
they
like
don't talk above.
Right.
Yeah.
And so it's good. So I would highly recommend, first of all, you do these things, be aware of the things that she just spoke about.
Yes.
Okay, so you have an understanding.
Mm-hmm.
And then just have Home and Local Services do it.
Yes, so go out to our website. I don't know if some of our clients, Ann Maria or somebody that's still on, you guys can put the link in. It's themilliondollarplumber.com/
Power Tools?
Power Tools.
Right,
there might be
right.
a dash in between Power but
there's
Tools.
There's up to the menu.
Go
there's
check
a Power
out,
Tools.
Yeah,
so you can get
somebody go put the link in there. That would be very helpful.
And it's just helpful. Lets them know you came from us and they know, they're going to take care of you as a...
They take extra good care of
Potty
Talk Live and Million Dollar Plumber people. Right. So, anyway, great show.
Yeah, actually,
Yeah, I'm having that information.
I love that's a company we like. I mean, we talked about it. I don't want to go out, but mm-hmm. we've been around. We've been in this industry for a long, long, long time. And even though there's top shelf companies that we really like, you know, that are really impressed with, you know, something like Kick Charge, mm-hmm. you know, Service Titan, right? We use Applicant Pro.
Is there,
you know, this coming across Home and Local Services, which we got to give credit to one of our clients came across.
Tyee's.
Thank you so much. And how they do it. Like the way she was speaking on some things is just how we speak and how we talk on these things. If you notice, it's customer-centered,
mm-hmm.
you know,
yes.
about the customer. It's not about their technology,
no.
which the technology is different, is better than what else is out there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Right.
But it's all
customer-centered.
It's all centered around the customer.
They really do want you to succeed.
Yeah.
I mean, that really is their heart.
So it's like, wow, I wish I would have thought of this.
I know. Yeah, well.
So there we go.
We thought of this. You know what else you thought of?
What? The Success Academy. Okay. In fact, we're getting ready to do. I'm so impressed. I'm going to have Miss Katie said that she would do a class in the Success Academy. Okay, so we're going to be doing that here in the future here pretty soon.
Mm-hmm.
But the Success Academy, everything is there for you. Okay, we walk you through everything to build your successful, self-sustaining, and profitable plumbing business.
Mm-hmm.
All right, we want you know how to build a $1 million plumbing business and have a life too. Okay,
mm-hmm.
it's all in the Success Academy, laid out for you, easy, bite-sized yeah. modules. Okay.
Mm-hmm. 14-day free trial for now.
For now, that's going away soon.
TikTok,
hey,
TikTok.
If you're serious, grab it. Okay, 14-day free trial, get you in there,
mm-hmm.
then we hook you. You know,
that's
just
right.
kind of a thing. You see how good it is?
right.
All right, check it out. Simply type success in the comments or go to themilliondollarplumber.com/success
mm-hmm.
and grab your free trial. So there
okay.
we go.
All right,
great show. Thanks again to Miss Katie. All right, and thank you for joining us. As always, I want to remind you that you are purposely and wonderfully created. You were created to do great things. Plumb like a champion.
Thank you for tuning in to Potty Talk Live with Richard Behney, the Million Dollar Plumber. If you enjoyed this show, share it now.
Just do it.
To catch past episodes and get alerts for new episodes, turn notifications on now and join us again for more tips, techniques, and strategies to help you grow your plumbing business.